A quick note about this podcast. Information is provided for educational purposes only and is not intended to include or constitute financial product advice. You should obtain independent advice from an Australian Financial Services licensee before making any investment decisions. Please refer to ASX's full disclaimer with respect to this podcast on the school's Share Market Game teacher resources page on the ASX website.
Welcome to a new podcast series of ASX's School Share Market Game. My name is Teresa Lindfeld. I am the Senior Manager, Enterprise Marketing, Brand and Content at ASX, and I'm also responsible for the Share Market Game. In this series, we cover the theme of investing advice for my teenage self, and we talk to some investment experts who will share how they got involved in investing, what they were like as teenagers, and what they wish they knew about investing now that they are older and wiser. We hope that this content will spark your curiosity and continue your investment journey as you start learning about the share market, how to invest, and different types of investments. And today I am delighted to welcome to the School Share Market Game podcast the CEO of the Australian Shareholders Association, Rachel Waterhouse.
Thank you, Teresa.
Thanks for joining us today, Rachel. So Rachel has got extensive, more than 20 years experience in the finance industry. She's worked for the Governance Institute. She's worked in governance. She's worked in finance. And why don't you tell us a little bit about what the Australian Shareholders Association does, Rachel, because it's a really interesting and important organisation.
So I'm the CEO of Australian Shareholders Association, and we have over 7,000 members, and we're a not-for-profit organisation. So we're here to protect retail shareholder rights and also provide investor education to our members. When providing education, we do provide access to member meetings, webinars, conferences, and a magazine. So really here to help those on their learning journey with investing.
That's fantastic, Rachel. So tell us about what you're doing today on a day-to-day basis and how you got to work in finance.
Yeah, so I have had a career in finance and associations for over 20 years, and I started off working in finance in marketing and also product management, which was really interesting and a good grounding in the understanding of how finance works. From there, I moved into association management and have worked at the Australian Institute of Company Directors and Governance Institute. And then I saw a job ad for Australian Shareholders Association for the CEO role, and I was in a general manager role, and I thought, all right, well, you've got to be in it to win it. And I didn't know that I would get the role, but I applied. And I've been in the role now for about 18 months, really enjoy it, work with a small team, that's great. And we also have over 200 volunteers working together on putting together member meetings for our members and also monitoring about 200 ASX companies.
So I think you've mentioned to me before that you attend a whole bunch of meetings, AGMs, half-year results and those kinds of things. So what do you look at when you attend those?
Yeah, we have our volunteers who are members. They're allocated a specific company and they work together as well on a buddy system. And they're looking at a company and how is it performing? So is it performing well over, you know, a 5-year period? What's the remuneration for the CEO? Is it appropriate? And the strategy going forward. And then what they do is they prepare voting intentions for members that they can access to really help them get up to speed on a company, how it's performing, and how they may want to vote at the upcoming AGM.
So you obviously got into the finance industry as an adult, but tell us about what you were like as a teenager. Were you interested in finances at all?
Yes, I was. So as far as my personal journey, my mother was a single parent and she installed in us the focus on working hard to achieve your goals, but also save and budget. So I learned a lot from my mother as a teenager on how to do that. I didn't learn a lot about investing at that point in time, but I did try to extend myself through doing economics at high school and also reading the Australian Financial Review. Now, I couldn't understand most of it when I was in years 11 and 12, but I kept on reading it about once a week and then learning more about companies, about investing, about economics, which really helps you over time to grow in how you might be an investor in the future.
And what do you wish that you knew when you were a teenager about investing?
I wish I knew that how much it had grown on average. Now, the share market goes up and it goes down, but I wish I had have known that generally over a long period of time it goes up. And the sooner you get involved in investing and in shares, the more you will learn. You will make bad mistakes. So I have, like most investors, but I've also made good ones. And when you do make a mistake, that's how you learn. So if I had gotten into it earlier, you know, I might have more money in my investment. So I would say when you get to 18, really think about what's your investment strategy and start investing. But to invest, you need to make money, you need to save so you can invest in shares, and you could start small.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think there's a lot of tools and platforms now to allow you to actually start small as well. So you've got three kids, two teenagers. How are you helping them get on this investment journey and learn more about investing?
Yeah, I'm trying to take the learnings I had as a teenager with my mother as far as you need to earn, you need to budget, you need to save, and then add on, you need to invest. We do have conversations at the dinner table. Now, not every night. I have been warned by the children not to speak about it all the time, but we do have conversations, and it is getting their interest in companies. Like, what companies would you invest in if you had money? The important part is why. And having that conversation and hearing the children talk and think about it. And, you know, they don't always want to listen to their parents, so that's fine, but starting to get them to think about it. And it's small things. It's also having the news on occasionally of an evening and the finance section, and it's a minute or 2 minutes, and then having a conversation about what that means.
Okay, fantastic. So if you had to tell your teenage self one thing about investing, what would that one thing be?
I would really think about compounding. Now, Albert Einstein talks about it as the eighth wonder of the world. Now, I didn't know that when I was a teenager, but if you put a small amount aside and you invest regularly, you will be able to make money that will help you in the long term. And our money is around ensuring you've got the lifestyle that you need for the future. And it could be as simple as putting $500 away, $20 once a month. Over 20 years, you'll have $17,000 potentially. So, you know, get started early and start investing.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a great tip. So we've got a vast amount of students about to start playing the share market game, or as they listen to this, perhaps playing already. What is the one tip that you would give them when they're playing the share market game, perhaps looking at what's happening in markets at the moment, or just generally in terms of strategies that they should apply?
I would suggest that you do your research and you really think about the companies that you are going to invest in. You want to make sure that they're a company that performs well over time and have confidence in the strategy of that organisation. Now, if you're not sure where to look, go onto their website, look in the strategy section, have a look at their annual report, and that will give you a sense of what it is. But, you know, think about who are their competitors, how much market share do they have, can they grow? And then if you've got confidence, put it in your portfolio.
So Rachel, tell us about some of the resources that our players of the school share market game could potentially use on your website that might help them.
Yeah, you can come on to australianshareholders.com.au and look at the companies we monitor. And in there, if you put the company that you'd like to learn more about, search for it and you will see the voting intentions. And those voting intentions have been put together by ASA members.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Rachel.
Thank you, Teresa.
Are you keen to learn more? Why not visit the ASX blog, asx.com.au/blog, for a wide range of articles, videos and insights from ASX experts, listed companies and investment professionals.